Hey guys, it's Queen Deja, and in today's video, I will be reacting to. Honestly, really, I don't know how in the world I'm going to do this, but this will either be episodes 13 and 14 of Saki Side A, or just episode 13. I'm not sure because I just found out these episodes are 20. These last four episodes are 29 minutes, and I only have from now until I go to work to get this ish done. Yeah, I know, I'm not really supposed to be working on a Friday, but. My boss needs me in here today, so I'm like, great. But other than that, let's go ahead and get started with episode 13 and 3, 2, 1, go. Much. I hope she is too. I mean, because the last time we saw, she used way too much of her ability. Hell, that could be all whole four episodes that I have left. Yeah. Points, please. I mean, she's speaking the same as you, which is winning. But still trying your best, but winning. No. Well, Which is a little weird to go for cheap hands, but she has to do what she has to do. But baby, you make it a little obvious for her to go after you. Her little twitch. Okay. I mean, 'cause she's been moving for the last couple of minutes. It's interesting. Oh shit. Okay. Your turn. Yes, your turn. Or basically trying to avoid that. I mean, and right now you're falling in everybody's trap except the first year. Ow. I really just think the first year is not going to come back from that because look how far the other three are compared to her and the fact that she cannot get a hand. Meaning, it's just like you either need to continue trying or just go ahead and give up while you can and then just accept defeat. But I feel like she's not going to back down without a fight. None of these girls are. Damn. She want to say it again 'cause she tired. You still did good. Okay. Yeah, you can't win all of them. Aw. Oh, it was inevitable. The fact that she is going in on strong. Would I look good? There you go. Everybody, so come on now. Oh. Damn. Her ability is tree like, what the Okay. I will say, having these last four episodes, like 30 minutes, excuse me, instead of the initial 25 or 24 minutes, is not that long and it's not that bad. It's just when I was like getting ready, because it's now 10:08, and like I said, I don't have to be to work until a specific time. I'm like, am I gonna be able to get all this before done before I go to work? And I should have enough time, but I'm trying to get it done so I don't have to stress about it. But this was a really good episode, and I think I'm gonna go ahead and watch the next episode after this, so just to have these two together. But these matches are just going and they're rolling, and I like that. I don't like the fact that it's like, okay, 1 minute, it's like, here's a match, we stop for a couple of minutes and such, and then we're instantly starting into it. I just really like how we stop, the one match finished and concluded, and then we instantly went into the next match, and that's good because the fact is we are so close into the finals and we're trying to see who's going to overtake these girls. But yeah, I'm glad everybody still did good. Like, damn. And even with Kuro and her situation of practicing, everybody's still trying their damn best because that's all you really can do in this moment for them. Now, also with the fact is that the first year's girls team is over here talking about Sagi. I mean, like, yeah, she's probably related. I mean, yeah, we all know. I know. But y'all don't know. And y'all have to find out and stuff. But I think once when the characters specifically do find out that Saki is related to her, that's when we're gonna be like, oh, so then it makes sense of why she did this and why she did that and da 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 da. Because from what we were told in the previous series and any match that her and her Saki and her sister had, of course, Saki's sister was always overtaking her. So it was inevitable. Saki would always lose, and that's why she's so deathly afraid of her sister, plus a whole bunch of other things, especially with the situation of their parents and everything else. But still, at the same time, she wants to bring her sister home. So hopefully, within not this next episode, but the last two episodes of this show before we get into the next part, we do at least get to see something of a match between those two. I'm hoping and praying, but of course, we gotta wait and see. But go ahead and pause the video, and I will see you guys in 1 second for episode 14. Okay, episode 14 in 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, no, wait, 3, 2, 1, go. No, she's just silly. Damn, already. We not even like 3 minutes into the episode, and they're like, boom. Damn. Poor baby. Right, way too scary. What? I mean, I know that was in the preview, but what the fuck? Basically. Somebody already had your upper hand. And you're sleepy. Be seriously not gonna talk about what the hell she wearing? Okay. At first, I'm like, in the back of my mind, I'm like, Damn, saw right through you. I mean, but we knew that was gonna happen though. And the same thing with Arata. It is, but it's something that she's very much like grown on. And she's somewhat made it her own because, I mean, yes, taking the lessons of some of someone else and the teachings of it, and eventually making something that was someone else into your own is a good thing. And besides, she's always seemed like an old-fashioned girl ever since I've seen her and got first impressions on her. Authoria played into her trap without even realizing it. Aww. You want to do a practice match? No, it seems like it's the other way. Yep. The other way around. She gonna open her eyes. Yep. I mean, cause she can't be. She shouldn't have been asleep like what that long. The fact that we gotta wait until next week to see the conclusion. Like, oh my God. That, I mean, I get it, but it's just, it was getting so hype and so like on the edge of your seat. And then I'm looking at the time and I'm like, oh shit, we're almost done with the episode. Or we're really almost done with the episode. But like, oh, out of that, like everyone is kicking ass and trying their best and taking names and such. And I'm super afraid about how this is gonna conclude all next week. And you know, maybe if I have time tonight, depending on excuse me again. When I get home and such, maybe I'll go ahead and watch the episode so that I know how to do it next week when I come home from work. But like, oh. The tension is near, dear, dire high, and anything else could happen in these last couple of parts for the finale for these next two episodes. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction view towards episodes 13 and 14 of Saki Side A. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like, it really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel and make videos every single day. Join the Master Squad, and of course, I will see you guys officially all next Monday for everybody else, and next Saturday for Patreons for the final two episodes of Saki Side A. But until then, I will see you guys all next time. Bye, guys.